Bradley. It is time. Karen. Karen Holland.
It is time right now. Right now.
I was the sick one.
That was it.
That was me being the sick one.
Thank you. Thank you.
not enough copies of the bulletin. So I was running over to see if I could make the computer like me, but I'm glad you're all here tonight. So Merry Christmas Eve. Welcome to worship if you've not been here before. I just have a couple of housekeeping. The bathrooms are located, if you go down this hallway and kind of to the left, there's a little kitchenette, and there are bathrooms on either side of the kitchenette. So feel free to use those as needed. We also are having communion with disposable glasses. We will collect them though. So what you'll do is you will come up. We usually start with this side. You'll come up. You can kneel or stand as you're comfortable. You'll receive the bread from me, the wine from Fred. We also have gluten-free wafers and grape juice available, so if that's something you need, just let Fred or me know, and we will take care of that. And then what you'll do is return to your seat by the side aisles, and there will be a person helping to show you where to collect your, standing on either side here, collecting your used glasses. So, a couple of other announcements. I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who's been working so hard to put this service together, to Sunny and Kelly, and we've had the choir. Our choir is a mighty few this evening. Three of our choir members got sick in the last 24 hours, so we are a mighty quartet. So you can pray for us during our songs. We're all holding down one part, and we're going to do the best we can. So, but it should be a good service. Also, thank you to the Altar Guild, everyone who came in to help make this church beautiful. We're just so grateful. Thank you. Next week, I will be off on vacation, as will Kelly in the office. So the office is closed next week. If you need us, my cell phone is in the bulletin. I will be in Erie or at home in Edinburgh. So feel free to call if there's an emergency. But if you call the church or email the church, you will not hear from us probably until the 2nd. So my cell phone is the way to get a hold of us if there's an emergency. So are there any other announcements that I am forgetting tonight? All right. Do you all have your candles? Yes? All right, great, good. So you're all ready for Silent Night then. So, all right, then we will begin with our call to worship. Please stand as you are able. Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
He is the light no darkness can overcome.
At darkest night, we gather to celebrate the great light of our salvation.
With the heavenly host, we sing, glory to God in the highest heaven.
In Christ, God's word is made flesh and lives among us.
With the shepherds, we will tell of the wonders we have seen and heard.
And now we'll begin with our gathering hymn, hymn number 283.
Oh,
shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wait to the brightness of his glory. Through your only Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
The first reading tonight is from Isaiah, the 9th chapter. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across the shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is Psalm 96. It will be read responsibly. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Proclaim God's salvation from day to day.
Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and great is his greatness, more to hear than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nation, they are but idols, but you, O Lord, have made the heavens.
Majesty and magnificence are in your presence. Power and splendor are in your sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor and use of the holy name. Bring offerings into the courts of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth.
Tell out among the nations, the Lord is king. The one who made the world so firm that it cannot be moved, will judge the peoples with equity.
Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea hunger and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy at your coming. For you come from the Lord.
You will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth. The second reading is from Titus, the 2nd chapter. The grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity, and purify for himself a people of his own, who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for the gospel.
We'll sing verses 1 and 2 of hymn number 300.
Thank you.
saying verses 3 and 4 after the gospel, so keep your finger in it. All right. The gospel according to Luke, the second chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Now in that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their sheep by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been foretold them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
All right. Yeah. Oh, yes. Three and four. Got it right. saying good morning to everybody. I have a question for you. Are you guys excited for tomorrow?
Yes.
What are you excited for? Presents, what else? Family?
Food.
Pizza in your fridge, we're ready for pizza. You have a list of things that you're
excited for. And those
are
the
things that you're excited for. Oh, yeah. That's awesome. So we're all excited. And you know what the hardest thing about being excited is? You know?
Waiting.
Waiting. Yes. Waiting. Oh, my gosh. I hate waiting. I'm ready. I've been ready. But, you know, Advent is all about waiting.
I can't wait until Christmas. Like, not the type of, like, can't wait, like, the line, but, like, the actual can't wait.
You actually cannot wait. I get it. I am like that. Are you going to be able to sleep tonight? That's what I want to know. Can you sleep tonight, or are you going to be too excited?
I can't sleep tonight. I can only push my head into the pillow.
Okay. Well, do your best so your parents get sleep. Because we want Elena and Matt to have sleep too. So we have been waiting and waiting and waiting for Jesus to come. And tomorrow, and kind of tonight because we're all gathered here and we don't have church tomorrow. Tonight and tomorrow we celebrate that Jesus is here. Yay!
And Santa.
And Santa. Yes. We're waiting for lots of things. And you know what I think is the coolest part about Jesus coming to earth? You know what's really cool? Jesus came to earth, and he was like, I know that this earth is a little bit messy sometimes. It's a little bit full of some not great stuff sometimes. But you know what? Jesus wasn't like, hey, I'm not coming to that earth and being with those people because they don't have it together. I don't know about any other moms, but I feel sometimes like I don't have it together right about Christmas time. But Jesus says, I'm still going to come, and I'm going to be with you, even in the moments when things seem darkest or when things seem not all put together and shiny and bright. And so that's the God we have. So tomorrow's going to be a lot of fun. But also remember that when things aren't as fun, when things feel a little off, God still is there with us, even when we feel sad or angry or hurt, that even if it's not as shiny as Christmas, God still loves us and is still with us. So let's pray. Dear God,
thank you
for being with us,
for being with us.
Coming to us
tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
You guys have a lot of energy. We'll just pray for all the parents. Chaotically run out all that Christmas energy downstairs, 90% sure. So. All right. Blessed Are You Who Bear the Light by Jan Richardson. Blessed are you who bear the light in unbearable times, who testify to its endurance amid the unendurable, who bear witness to persistence when everything seems in shadow and grief. Blessed are you in whom the light lives, in whom the brightness blazes. Your heart a chapel, an altar where in the deepest night can be seen the fire that shines forth in you, in unaccountable faith, in stubborn hope, in love that illumines every broken thing it finds. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. Tonight, we gather here to give thanks for this light, that centuries ago, on a star-filled night, our Savior was born for us. Our God came to dwell with us and make his home with us. That on a silent night, in a city bursting to the seams with people, a newborn's cry rang out. A baby was born for us. And on that night, everything changed. Our God incarnate came to be with us to show us what love and light and hope looked like. A Christ who was rocked as an infant, became a curious child, and grew up to live in this world, caring for others, showing us the way, and teaching us what the kingdom of God truly looks like. And while so many of the pictures that we see of this holy night look perfect, everything in its proper place and order, we know that the truth of the first night is that Christ was born into a messy, broken world, much like the one that we inhabit today. He was born to a poor couple, surrounded by sickness and pain, hunger and want. He was born into a world full of violence and grief, and war and power-hungry rulers. And today he comes again to a world broken by violence, to those of us who know all too well grief, want, need, and heartache. And even then, in the realistic moments of this season, he makes a home here too. He dwells with us in the places that have been shattered and offers us a stubborn hope to hold on to, a light that cannot be overcome, even by the darkest places in our hearts and our world. This light shines, reflecting the love of a God who cherishes each one of us, no matter where we've struggled, what burdens we bring with us this day, what lost loved ones or dreams we carry. We are invited to lay them at the manger, along with our gifts of praise and faith, our gifts of love and joy. God does not expect of us a Thomas Kincaid life. That is not what he lived, and that is not what we live either. What God promises for us instead is an enduring love that chases after us, a light to guide our steps and illumine the dark or the bleakness, a hope that points always to the kingdom of God in its fullness, and a Savior who comforts us and offers us peace. A God who knows us, all of us, and still calls us his own. A Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This light that we hear about and will soon light up this church as we share a spark of it with one another is not easily put out. It is steadfast. This light is not wavering or dismissive or gives up when things get hard. It reminds us that we do not ever go this road alone. That we always have a God who loves us enough to come to earth, loves us enough to die on a cross, loves us enough to rise again, loves us as we are, not the perfect picture, perfect self that we'd love to be. Our God loves us. And and that light springs forth to illumine all the places where we and others feel isolated and alone, surrounding us with the true joy of this birth. And that is the joy that we are sent out into this world to carry, the light we bear to others, a light that brings wholeness and healing, comfort and love, a hope that sees the world as it truly is and still promises us more. The good news of our Savior's birth is not that the world is perfect, but that our perfect God came to this imperfect world and made a home here. Our God is here in the midst of the messiness. And this light, this love, can never, ever be overcome. So tonight we give thanks to our Christ, our newborn King. Amen. We'll now stand and sing our hymn of the day, hymn number 289.
We look for the resurrection of the dead Trusting in God's good news of great joy for all people, we offer our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and the world God loves. Glory to you, God, for the song of the angels, proclaiming to the world Christ's holy birth. Give your church a joyful song to sing, that we bring the good news of peace and salvation to all people. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you. Glory to you, God, for the stars that shine in the depth of the night, provoke awe in our hearts and at the expansive mystery of the cosmos. Open us to find beauty in the clear darkness of night and in the first glimmers of dawn. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the child born to us, who establishes a kingdom of justice and righteousness. Break bonds of oppression, bring reconciliation to warring lands, and establish peace from this time onward and forevermore. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for Mary's loving care. Lead us to tend to one another in time of need. Share the comfort of your presence with all people tonight who are alone or separated from loved ones due to estrangement, incarceration, or illness, especially Bob, Doreen, Leona, Marge, Sue, Mary, Jane, Peggy, Ed, Evie, Betty, Pat, Susan, Rita, Sandy, Carmen, Nancy, Vicki, Alma, Carol, Sue, Andy, Jeff, Timothy, Eloise, Missy, Brett, Karen, Frank, Linda, Charlotte, Mark, Tressa, Heidi, Mike, Burton, Richard, Dane, Laura, Matt, Kathy, Wanda, Richard, Darlene, John, Chuck, friends and family of Brian, Paul, and families of Hayden. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the faithfulness of the shepherds in their vocation. Grant rest to any who feel exhausted from their work during this season. Retail and restaurant workers, church musicians, administrative staff, clergy, organizers of charitable giving events, and service workers doing essential tasks. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the multitude of the heavenly hosts. We rejoice in the zeal of all your saints, especially those who have witnessed the appearing of your grace and who revel and who reveal to us your salvation for all. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace.
Amen.
Now may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
We share that peace with one another as you feel comfortable.
Thank you.
Prepare us to receive the grace and truth you offer at this table, and renew in us the song of your salvation. In Jesus Christ, our Lord, our Savior, and Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
strengthen you and keep you in his peace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Emmanuel, God with us, you grace us with life and breath and give us bread for the journey. Send us out in service to this world that you love, telling the amazing news of your coming to be Savior and Lord of all.
Amen. Amen.
From John chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave the power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. We'll now sing hymn number 281.
Christ is born. Go tell it on the mountain and everywhere.
Thanks be to God.